Good morning, dear students. Yesterday we were doing a lecture of Northland. So we were discussing question answers. So we were discussing question answer for that. So for that, yesterday we were doing question answer of the poem A Legend of Northland. So we were discussing question answers for that, and I think we were discussing question number 4. How does the woodpecker get her food? See, woodpecker is the name of a bird. Okay, and what kind of food this bird eats? I told you yesterday. Tell me, which kind of food does it eat? Yes, very good. Only one student was present in class. Others were in their bed. Worms and insects. So this was the basic food of woodpecker. And how does he get his food? By hitting hard on hard trees, hard surface of trees. He searches food here and there. You can tell about his hard beak. He makes holes on the surface of trees. On the surface of trees. So in this way, that is his routine that is told about. So by following such kind of routine, he is able to get her food. So bachche, you can pick up all the points. You can pick up all the points, and with the help of these points, you can frame your answer. Yes. You are repeating all the points that I have written, but you are not able to impress me. You are not having self declaration form and you are sitting in class. Yes, you tell some points from your own side. Yes, he also searches food on the hard bark of a tree. Hard bark of a tree. So bachche, pick up all the points that I have written in front of you. With the help of all these points, you can frame a very good answer. So start framing. Hurry up. Start framing. I'm giving you 2 minutes to frame this answer. Hurry up. Those who are ready, they can raise their hands. Afterwards, this answer can be asked from any of the child. So Simran, you show me your face, because there can be one fake ID. Show me your face for 1 minute. Show me your face, and you can keep your camera off afterwards. Okay, now tell me this answer. Yes, Simran, unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I'm so sorry to interrupt, ma'am, but I don't know. I just entered the class right now. I wasn't able to check the group. And ma'am, can you please tell me what we did till now?
This question is going on that you have to tell about woodpecker. What kind of, how does he get his, how does it get her food? Okay. So many points are given. Various kind of activities of woodpecker is given here. So with the help of given points, you have to frame this answer. Okay. So by that time, Dhiren, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, according to the story of Northern Land, they used to tell the children a story that the woodpeckers was born by a curse of one saint, whose name was Saint Peterson. And Saint Peterson gave a curse to one lady who was not able to give a single cake to him as he was...
Wait. See, in this answer, you are not supposed to tell the whole story that it was Saint Peter, he gave a curse. The question you have, because in your paper, there can be answer 2 marks. So you just focus only all the activities of woodpecker, that how does it get food? What kind of activities does it do? What kind of, you can say, physical feature it has? What kind of features help him to provide food? Like it has a very hard beak that can be, that he can always hit on the hard surface or on the bark of a tree. Okay? So pick up all the points which are written on the blackboard. Now,
okay, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, the woodpecker is, as given in the stories, feeds on worms and other insects. It also finds the worms and insects in the holes of trees and is always busy in hitting the outer layer of tree in making his home and also trying to find different types of insects. According to the curse, the woodpecker is always has to bore and bore for the food. It also don't deserve comforts of life, just like the lady who didn't give him say in the cake.
Okay. Now, other students also get ready with your answer. Other students also get ready with your answer. From offline, only one is raising hand. Yes, Kavarnur, you tell me. Okay, you go tell me, you tell me this one. Renuka. Now listen, bachche, let's move to next question. Next question is very much interesting. It is one of my favorite questions from this poem. Do you think that the old lady would have been so ungenerous if she had known who Saint Peter really was? See, Saint Peter, when he asked for that piece of cake, she did not give that piece of cake to that Saint Peter because she was not known to that person that he is a saint. He is a Saint Peter, that you can say godly personality. But if she had known this thing earlier, that he was actually Saint Peter, so do you think that old lady would have been so ungenerous? Ungenerous means she would be having, she would be so unkind. So what would she have done then? It means if she had known, if she had known who Saint Peter really was, so definitely she would have given a very large piece of cake to that Saint Peter. Why? So to seek his blessings. For the greed of blessings. Okay. So who wants to tell me this answer? Hurry up. Because in this answer, your viewpoint and other viewpoints can be quite different. So all of you try to speak. What do you think? So I'm giving you 1 minute to think about this. Or if she had known about that Saint Peter, so she would have treated him in the same manner. Tell me. Okay. So Ridhima, are you ready with this answer? Okay, Arzu, you tell me, then I will be listening from Ridhima, then other students. Yes, Arzu?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
No, the old lady would not have been so ungenerous if she had known who Saint Peter really was. Instead, she would have welcomed him in her house happily and given him several large cakes to please him and get his blessings.
Okay. So she is saying that she would have given him a very warm welcome. So let's make this answer. All of you start typing in chat box. So first of all, if she would have known about that person, so what activities she would have done? If she had, yes, would have. Godly personality. She would have given him a warm welcome, served with hospitality, shown gestures of love, respect, generosity, kind, humble. See, such kind of gesture would have been seen by that lady. Why so? Why so? It means to please. Please means to make him happy. To please Saint Peter. And why did he do all the, why did she do all these activities? To seek blessings. Okay. So with the help of 1, 2, 3, 4 points, you can frame a very good answer. But internally, which traits, personality traits comes in front of us? She was doing for, she would have done all the things for, yes. So internally, she would have all the things only for her greed. So it means she was, internally she was selfish, greedy, mean. Okay? Yes. Godly personality. If she would have known that Saint Peter, for that Saint Peter, you can write down word for godly personality. Clear? So many points I have shared with you. Now you can frame a very good answer. Those who will not be framing these answers, I'm going to mark them absent today, because 31 online are there, 7 offline are there. So 38. So Ridhima, you tell me this answer.
No, according to me, she would not have done this. On the contrary, she would have given him a large piece of cake to him to make him happy with great to get a handsome return. And if she know about that, the Saint Peter is a godly personality, she would definitely ask and treat him like a very good personality with full of mentality, kindness, and lots of love. And in demand, she will absolutely ask for a good gift.
That line, a personality line, that you change that line. Otherwise, it was okay.
She would have welcomed, as he was a godly personality and was very focused.
Okay, Nitya, you tell me this answer. After Nitya, Divya should be ready. Okay. Now, Divya, you tell me this answer.
Divya? Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. No, I think she would be so generous if she know that Saint Peter was a godly personality. She would have given him a warm welcome. Her gesture would be completely opposite. She would offer him hospitality and a large piece of cake to satisfy his hunger, as he was a saint and could bless her with wealth. But internally, she was selfish, greedy, and couldn't help the poor people.
Renuka. Very nice. Now, Ekjot.
Yes, ma'am. Even if the lady had known who Saint Peter really was, she would not have been generous to him. She would not have given him a cake even then. We are told that she was utterly selfish and greedy, and such people rarely part with their things.
Okay. Good.
Now let's move to next question. Is this a true story? Which part of this poem do you feel is the most important? Do you think it is a true story?
Yes, ma'am.
Can I transform you in food packer? Tell me. Can I change you in Anna? You can say bird. I don't think so. So what do you think? Is this a true story? So what do you think? Offline students are really enjoying this chapter. They are telling me 50-50. So what do you think? It is a ballad. It has been transformed from one generation to another. It might be because, as Kavarnur is saying, that in previous time there were some supernatural powers. So using those supernatural power, yes, in Ramayana and Mahabharata we have seen. Yes, there are abundance of stories like this in our epics. So this story has been, I think, transformed. This story has been told from one generation to another, and another generation passes to next generation, and now it has reached to us. But what do you think? Yes. So which part of this poem do you feel is the most important? Which part of the poem is most important? Hurry up. Think about this. Bachche, I don't want to listen your, you can say, Hindi epic story. Discussion should be done in English. Okay, whatever you think about this poem, tell me in English. Hurry up. Hurry up, tell me. Tell me. Now you are grown up, you are a student of 9th class. If I tell you in that area it happened, that lady was doing like this. Okay, one of the beggar came and he gave a curse. That beggar came, actually it was a godly figure. Okay, so that lady did not give alms to that person. So what happened? The person was transformed. Okay, so you should never become selfish. You should always help poor. Okay, so this punishment. So would you believe? Would you believe in today's world? No. Because it cannot be a true story. It was basically a legend which carries on, which passed from one generation to another. Okay? And which part of the story do you think was interesting one? Part of the poem, part only, not whole poem, only one part. Only one part that was so interesting. Hey, just wait, Dipanshi wants to tell. Yes, Dipanshi, you tell me.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yes.
No, No, this is not a true story. This is a story narrated by people in the Northland, but one can learn a lesson from it. The part of the poem where Saint Peter curses the old lady for being selfish is the most important part of the story. This is a lesson for people who are far selfish and don't deserve to be called human beings. They should learn respect the shelter provide to them, the food that they're getting from nature.
Yes. So what is that part of the story? When she was given punishment for her, you can say, selfishness, because God has given her every kind of comfort. Okay, she was enjoying every comfort of her life. So when one of the person, you can say, it was asking for food, okay, and she did not, she made one cake, then another. Consecutive, she has framed, she has baked 3 cakes, and she was so selfish, so mean, so greedy that she did not want to depart from them. So from all these gestures, what lesson do you learn? What moral do you think? So the moral will be that a person should not be selfish. If a person is selfish and greedy, that person should be given a severe punishment. So this was the most important part of the poem. This was the most important part of the poem.
Ma'am, your voice is not audible. Ma'am, it's not coming. Ma'am, okay, I'll answer. According to me, I don't think that it is a true story. The whole point of the story is to teach humans to be generous and kind. Human is a type of person who can cross any limit just for his greediness and needs. In the story, the old lady has everything and God has provided her all the comforts and safety. But she chose to be greedy, and then she was not very generous and didn't give a warm welcome to the person on her door. That's why Saint Peterson, whom she didn't knew was really the godly personality, cursed her to become a woodpecker. The whole point of the story is that when the woman turns into a bird, which is a woodpecker, so that she learn her lesson and be generous and kind to all the people. To be honest. Ma'am, your voice is not audible. We can only see your lips moving. Not even a single sound is coming.
Ma'am, may I give the answer? Okay, ma'am. No, it is not a true. This is not a true story that the woodpecker was changed. That the lady was changed to a woodpecker. This is just a story made in the Northland to teach the children that they shouldn't be greedy. God has given us everything from home to shelter, food to water, and this should be respected by the we human beings. As told in the story, most of the times the lady was being greedy. She didn't even ask the Saint Peterson to come in her home and take some rest. And moreover, when she was baking cakes, she thought that the cake was too big to give to him. So she baked three cakes as doing this, but she didn't even give a single one to the Saint Peter. And when Saint Peter that got angry, gave her an apt punishment for her this deed to transform in a woodpecker and to bore for food everywhere.
No, ma'am, you're not audible.
Ma'am, you're not audible.
Ma'am, are you pranking us? Ma'am, are you pranking us?
Ma'am, I think so that your audio is off from your side.
Yes,
check
ma'am.
Your audio.
I think it's a prank.
No, it's not a prank.
Ma'am is also smiling.
मैम कहते हैं आज मैं ऑफलाइन बच्चों को ही पढ़ाऊंगी
रिद्धिमा आंसर बता मैम कह रहे हैं
अच्छा आंसर बताती हूँ रुको कॉपी बंद कर दी थी मैंने
आप ही अच्छा चल रहा है
नो इट्स एन इमेजिनेटिव स्टोरी इट इज अ लेजेंड the third stanza of the poem is very important and according to me these poems are not real in real life and maybe it's real in the some of the times for some people and for their myths but in these generations now all these things don't happen and the story is totally for a good deed for us to how to be kind to everyone and not to be that greedy that to help even a single person in every bad situation
ma'am it's not coming